My name is Arindam Haldar and I am the Chief Executive Officer of SRL Limited. I operate out of our Gurgaon office. The global, the healthcare and diagnostics is no very different, is very different in structure compared to how is it in India. So if you look at a global diagnostic market, it's probably somewhere between 40 to 45 billion US dollar. Most of the numbers come from developed markets like US, Europe, Japan. Compared to that, while there are differing estimates of diagnostic market in India, because there is no formal way of capturing it, so informal estimate between a pathology and radiology will be far lesser than maybe around 8 to 9 billion dollar. Maybe half of it will be pathology and half of it will be radiology. The other key difference is as against a global framework where the diagnostics and the hospital industry goes hand in hand, a large part of that is funded by government. So say for example, developed market like UK, where more than 80% of healthcare spends is done by government, whereas in India, on more than 2/3 of healthcare market in India is funded by the private players. And the government investment in healthcare is far, far limited. The other key difference in the diagnostic market is the insurance cover. In global markets, diagnostic tests are also covered full-fledged in insurance, whereas the out-of-pocket expenses in diagnostic is far higher in India. So that's what I see as a key differentiator. Talking more on the Indian market, and if I talk about the pathology market, and as I said, as far as informal estimate, probably it will be about 30,000 crore. Almost half of it is the routine test. The biochemistry test that we talk about or the basic blood test. Whereas probably the higher order test, whether it's a molecular or genomics based test, will be in early single digit in terms of the percentage salience. It's growing. It has been growing at a large space over the last maybe many decades. However, it is still very fragmented and a large part of the diagnostic market is still ruled by unorganized and single lab owners. So I see four key trends in Indian diagnostic market. One is the movement towards molecular pathology and genetic based test. Today, in terms of salience, those tests are in single digit in percentage terms. However, over the next 5 years, they are going to grow anywhere between 7 to 10 times. And a lot of new technology is coming in the area of prenatal and neonatal testing, in early detection of influenza virus, indeed detection of certain strains in early cancer. Second trend is about digitization in diagnostics and digitization across the value chain, whether it's in the pre-analytical area, which is your sample collection and logistics, or indeed in the reporting format, which is the area of data analytics. And there will be also a role of artificial intelligence coming in, machine learning coming in certain areas of diagnostic like cytogenetics or histopathology. We are also seeing a trend of consumerism or the critical role of consumer, which we have seen earlier in the pharma, in the OTC market, and we are seeing that trend coming in diagnostic market as well, where consumer will have a choice. And diagnostic companies have to wake up to this new phenomena where we'll have to make sure that to retain customer, we have to give far higher order service. Our current diagnostic reports are designed keeping doctors in mind. However, we'll have to think through how to make that far more patient and customer friendly. The fourth trend that I see is in the area of higher accessibility using both hardware like POCT as well as software. The trend that we'll see in home collection, because same as what has happened in the e-commerce industry, there will be a lot more home collection of samples happening. Role of POCT, which probably hasn't happened in the last 5 years, that's going to happen over the next 5 years for sure with new affordable technology coming in. And also the role of better analysis of report, being able to give far better health risk assessment to the patients. So that's going to happen as well. So those are the four key trends that I see. We at SRL are very much welcome the government's focus on both increasing the spends on healthcare as a percentage of GDP as well as the focus on wellness through the various initiative that the government is talking about, whether on primary healthcare, whether about the insurance policies that they have recently introduced, as well as what they are talking about, the wellness centers, 150,000 of them. Purely from a diagnostic industry angle, I think it fits in perfectly well, because diagnostics is at the beginning of primary healthcare, and we are extremely welcoming of the changes on focus. Only thing that I would like to say is there has to be a close coordination between the policy and the execution at the state level. SRL Diagnostic has a rich legacy of more than 23 years, helping patients in their journey towards better health. We have remained a pioneer right from day one by any measure that you can think of. Whether it is our geographic reach, we serve in more than 600 cities across the country. Whether it's the expanse of lab, we have more than 370 labs. Whether the number of doctors and technicians on our rolls, whether the number of patients that we serve. So we serve more than 15 million patients in an average year whose samples we test in a year. And it's of immense pride to me that we remain the most doctor preferred lab in the country. So SRL have had a lot of first in its journey over the last 23 years. We were the first ones to have a full-fledged R&D center, which is there in Mumbai for us. And we have been able to indigenize a lot of tests from the developed markets and made it accessible to patients in India. We also have by far the highest reach. We have more than 370 labs, 1,000 collection centers, and more than 5,000 collection points across the country. So we can reach samples from patients from anywhere and everywhere of the country to our reference labs. We also are extremely quality conscious and have the highest number of NABL accredited labs owned by a single company. And our focus on quality has always kept us ahead of the curve. And what people probably doesn't understand, a lot of quality parameters and a quality guidelines that we at SRL follow is not necessarily driven by government regulation, but it is all self-regulated. In line with the trends that we are seeing in the industry, we have put in a very exciting plan for SRL getting into the next year. We are expanding some of our menu in higher order test, whether it's in genomics or whether it's in molecular testing. We are also reaching out to a lot more patients through patient service center. Over the last 30 days, we must have opened about 30 patient service center across all the key cities of the country, whether it's Mumbai or Kolkata or Delhi or Lucknow or Surat. With advent of this PSCs, what we are essentially doing is giving a far more accessible and comfortable location for our patients to come in and get any of the 3,700 odd tests that we do get done. And we have a very efficient logistic system through which the samples are taken over and the tests are done at our state-of-the-art laboratories.